Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. So from today onwards, we're going to start a new course on what is data structures and algorithms. So every day we will be posting a new video on data structures. So make sure you attend every class. So let's start what is data structures and algorithms. So before getting into data structures, we need to know what is meant by data. So what is meant by data? Data is nothing but it is a collection of some information. So information consists of anything like phone numbers, names, login ID, passwords, anything. So anything which is used by the users comes under data. So what is meant by data structures then? So data is nothing but it's a collection of some information. So data structures is nothing but it is a way of organizing the data in an efficient way so that we can read and write the data in efficiently. Take an example of you developed an app and the app got so many installs and it has millions of users. So a user is trying to log in into the website. So what he does is he enters his email and password. You need to check whether his email and password is correct or wrong. So the information is stored in your database. So you need to query your database about the email and password, whether it is correct or wrong. So the data structures comes into play here. So if you used any good technique to optimize your data, the result will become in a very fast manner. Else the result will take so much time and the user will need to wait to get login into the website. So this is a crucial importance of data structures. Okay, so you got an idea about what is meant by data structures. So what is meant by data structures? A data structure is nothing but it is a way of organizing a data in an efficient way. So okay then, what is meant by algorithm? So an algorithm is nothing but the way we do to get the data in efficient manner is called an algorithm. So data structures and algorithms will work together to get an optimized application. To get some little information about data structures and algorithms, now let's see a real life example where data structures and algorithms will work together to get an optimized application. Now we will see an example where data structures will come into play in real life. To illustrate this example, I am taking the example of working a phone call. So before diving into the example, let me tell you how a phone call works briefly. So assume two places, Vizag and Hyderabad. So you are in Vizag and your friend is in Hyderabad. You need to call your friend who is in Hyderabad. So you are using SIM A and your friend is also using that same SIM. So whenever you make a phone call to your friend's phone number, the SIM in your phone will search for the nearest tower. So in this case, the nearest tower for me is tower 1. So this tower 1 will correspondingly search for the same tower in the area your friend is living in. So my friend is living in Hyderabad, right? So this is the nearest tower to him. So whatever I spoke in the phone call will be sent to my friend. So whatever my friend replies will be sent back to the same tower, and this tower will send back that same info to tower 1 where I am living. So the information will come again to the tower 1 and the tower 1 will send back to me. So this is how a phone call will work briefly. So what is the importance of data structures in this concept? So as you can see clearly, so as I told you earlier, your SIM will find the nearest tower to you. So this is the keyword here. So this is called importance of data structure. So how the SIM will find the nearest tower? It will use some algorithm. So this is how an algorithm, and this is the data structure. Hope you understand in this class. In the further classes, we will dive more into data structures and its core concepts. Thank you. Thank you.